finished main painting symbolizes 2 years of Herculean efforts on the part of the artist to represent an event that he witnessed and whose cause moved him to undertake this time-honored tradition of depicting wrongs through the subtle and elegant use of symbolism and allegory. Siete de Agosto, Allegory of a Farce, is both a depiction of an actual historical event as well as an elevation of the issues that this event raised to the level of timeless and universal relevance. It is an allegory of a farce because it depicts the farcical attempts to undermine artistic integrity and the dignity of the National Artist Awards. The painting depicts the following motifs and themes. A group of veiled female mourners in black represent the seven muses of the arts who mourn the death of the integrity of the National Artist Awards. Their clenched fists and abject expressions symbolize their faceless grief and rage at the travesty of the awards in 2009 and document the actual performance of the August 7 protest event at the CCP grounds. The female nude collapsing on the arms of black veiled mourners symbolizes the integrity of the National Artist Awards, whose acts on the right side of the painting, symbolized by the group of the seated harlequin and a group of courtier sycophants, cause for death. The laurel leaf crown on her head symbolizes the literary arts, while the palette on her left hand symbolizes the visual arts. The skull held aloft by one of the black mourners emphasizes the death of the integrity of the National Artist Awards, which occurs immediately below the skull. The white mannequin dressed in Filipiniana attire symbolizes the majority of passive Filipinos who witnesses but does not protest against the murder of the integrity of the National Artists Awards. Nonetheless, the mannequin's hand points to the scene of this death to acknowledge that a crime has indeed been committed. The dark structure in the background is the facade of the Cultural Center of the Philippines. A group of four sycophants dressed in demonic face masks surround the seated harlequin, whispering conspiratorially to her ears in order to gain favors in proclaiming new national artists. One sycophant shows her contempt of due process in the proper system of choosing the national artists by raising a dirty finger to the audience. The muscled youth in the foreground, wearing a native G-string, symbolizes the Filipino artists who are crying out for justice and due process in proclaiming the National Artist Awards. His pose of clenched fists also calls to mind the native resistance against oppression seen in the mythical hero Bernardo Carpio. The woman wearing a harlequin costume and seated in a glided throne represents executive authority, which has been corrupted by pride and vanity. Surrounded by courtiers who are sycophants, her eyes gleam with malice and haughty arrogance. She carries a swan feathered pen on one hand, which emphasizes her power. Swan feathered pens often appear in portraits of aristocratic noble women and monarchs in Europe, as well as her arrogance of power. The document and seal being trampled upon by the seated harlequin represents presidential decree number 208, signed by President Ferdinand Marcos on June 7, 1973, establishing the National Artist Awards. The seal symbolizes the National Artist Awards itself. The harlequin tramples upon these symbols as an act of supreme arrogance in administrating the National Artist Awards, violating the spirit and letter of the law, as well as the dignity of the award system. A group of protesters in the background scene are emphasized by three raised clenched fists, which symbolize the three general regions of the Philippines: Luzon, the Visayas, and Mindanao. These raised fists represent the collective national rage at the travesty committed against the National Artist Award. The dark cloaked and hooded figure pointing at the scene of the death of the integrity of the National Artist Awards is conscience. It reminds all protagonists that an injustice has occurred. He is carrying the scales of justice that symbolizes that judicial recourse will soon have its say on the matter. The bare-chested man wearing a native salakot, and who is also pointing to the scene of the death of integrity of the National Artist Awards, is Juan de la Cruz, the popular image of the ordinary Filipino, popularized by George Pineda in the early 1900s. He is aware of the injustice carried out by the group of the harlequin and sycophants before him, and who are themselves blind to his accusing stare. And his search for justice is symbolized by his carrying a native torch, or sulo, traditionally a symbol of enlightenment and the search for truth and justice. The flowering plant at the right foreground represents a cadena de amor, a fragrant plant that grows anywhere it is planted and symbolizes the resilience and resolve of the Filipino facing down and triumphing over adversity. Its fragrant blossoms also symbolize native culture and the arts. The reddening skies of sunset at the rear background symbolize the death of daylight and the advent of darkness through the oncoming night, a symbol of both death and the extinguishment of justice by evil. Its mournful colors are in sympathy with the darkened facade of the CCP, now seen as a new pantheon, which served as a proper backdrop to the scene of grieving and death in the foreground. Finally, to reaffirm his own artistic identity, Romulo Galicano included his iconic vertical stripes of colors to highlight the contemporary nature of his work. One which exists and breathes the equally relevant air of modernism to the traditional academic approach. Seen as a layered application to the traditional image, the final product is both a reiteration of the appeal of traditional academic painting and the updating of this tradition through new approaches of painting that adds upon the old and makes the idea of allegory and this work twofold. Both a reading of the codes and signs found in figurative representation, as well as a reading of the intervening stripes as a layered device that rejects the traditional view of painting as a window and returns it into the modern idea of art, a surface through which visual possibilities continue to fascinate and be explored by masters of academic innovation like Romulo Galicano.